What are your plans toward American citizens who are in Ukraine and might be there during an invasion? What scenarios would you put American troops to rescue and get Americans out?
There's not. That's a world war. When Americans and Russians start shooting at one another, we're in a very different world than we've ever been in.
Not even on behalf of simply evacuating Americans?
No. How do you do that? How do you even find them? This is not like I'm hoping that if, in fact, he's foolish enough to go in, he's smart enough not to, in fact, do anything that would negatively impact on American citizens. But what I've asked is American citizens should leave now. We're dealing with one of the largest armies in the world. This is a very different situation, and things could go crazy quickly.
You know it's funny when it rains and pours. They got money for wars but can't feed the poor. Said it ain't no hope for the youth, and the truth is it ain't no hope for the
enemy of this country is anyone who dares to criticize the mismanagement of Hillary Clinton and her friends.
It's time for what's left of the Republican Party that has any common sense, not just to say, okay, go help defend Ukraine against Putin, but to stand against those people in politics and government, in the media and elsewhere in our own country who are literally giving aid and comfort to an enemy of freedom and democracy. It can't continue because it plays right into the ambitions of not just Putin, but also President Xi of China to undermine democracy, to literally divide and conquer the West without ever invading us, but by setting us against each other.
Somebody so prepared to lose that there wouldn't even be a suspect until the trick was done.
I don't want a profile. I need a name. Who?
Who? I don't know who, but they had to have access to the warehouse. Plant the mirrors. Always a step ahead of me. And the FBI got past them, not once, not twice, but consistently. Almost as if they were on the end.
Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel, and thank you for joining me. So I had did a video about Hillary Clinton, and they struck it. They took it down. I guess I was a little bit of hurt ahead of her time, because the moment she started announcing her running for a re-election, they took the video down. They struck it. I guess calling her evil white lady was the wrong time at this time.
Putin is probably the richest man in the world. He has his palatial residences. That's really what got people in trouble in Russia, because they showed the arrogance and the wealth with which he lived. So it's about, what is this about?
Anyway, let's talk about magicians.
There were some reports about discrimination of people with Arabic or African roots. What can you tell us about that? Is this true? Did you experience something like this?
Yes, I experienced that. There's a lot of hostility from the white women. They really don't like us to be in the train. Somebody was telling me I have to stand up, I have to go out. If I don't, I'm not a Ukrainian, I shouldn't be in the train of a Ukrainian. I should find anywhere I should go to. So it's really, really, really sad that we have to face this. And they prefer their pets, their animals, even before a black man or a black woman. So it's really sad. I'm really traumatized, first of all. I really understand women first, then children first, then men, but not animals, not pets, before human beings.
You know, a lot of people don't understand this, but when it comes to magicians' tricks, it's a process to how they're done.
The exact replica of the little French guy's bank. So he's a plant.
was a dupe, not a plant. They chose him. They knew which seat he was in.
No, no, no. The audience picked the seat. Unless, of course, the audience didn't pick the seat.
They let them think they picked the seat.
We'll choose one at random, then. Jack.
Actually, they were just palming the ball with the seat number they wanted.
We are looking at row number 5. Henley, can I please have a seat number? Lucky number 13. And could you just confirm that this is, in fact, your seat?
He was selected. They programmed his mind to make him go to Las Vegas. And then they kept reinforcing until he did. They trailed him. They studied him. Nothing was left to chance.
Pardon me, sir. I got his measurements.
He had no idea he was their target. And they simply activated him in Vegas.
And once again, Merritt McKinney.
Is this true? Did you experience something like this?
Yes, I experienced that.
I remember watching this movie called Now You See Me, and it was about the long game. A lot, you get me, the long game. A man buries a card in a tree. He buries it in plastic or something in a case, and then he puts it into a nearby tree that had just started growing or something. And 30 years later, he comes back to that spot to perform a trick that looks like a car was inside of a tree. And that's the long game. He waited 30 years just to do one trick.
Inflation, the rising crime are both weighing down on President Biden's approval ratings right now. They're weighing down on Democrats as you head into the midterm. You say you're going to run again this year, but 29 of your fellow Democrats are not running for re-election. How worried are you about the midterms right now?
I don't agonize. I organize. And we are fully intent to win this election. Nothing less is at stake.
That would be bucking history.
Well, forget history. We're talking about future.
You know it's funny when it rains and pours. They got money for wars, but can't feed the poor. Said it ain't no hope for the youth, and the truth is it ain't no hope for the future.
You know, and when people say, well, the history says if presidents lose seats in the off year, presidents gain seat on the on seat. We didn't gain seats when President Biden won. We worked together to win the Senate, win the House, and win the White House. It was cumulative.
I look at Hillary Clinton. I look at Joe Biden. I look at Kamala Harris. I look at all these people, and you call them politicians. I call them magicians. I call them magicians because they're all playing tricks.
You do realize this is a game.
Oh, believe me, it's not a game.
It is a game. You're the game. You're being played. And your pathetic attempts at fawning to gain my trust. I mean,
they're all playing the long game. You get me? They got you looking over here when the real magic is happening over here.
I organize.
You get me? A woman stands at the podium and tells you that I'm doing this for the children, and you go, oh, it's for the kids, but it's not.
Especially those directly in harm's way. And this next woman, Elena Ganes, a tour guide by training, has sort of become the voice of those who are under attack, with reports coming from a bomb shelter just like this. Take a listen.
And you guys over there in the world, the world leaders, you are just watching this happening. Sanctions is nothing. Please protest. Simple citizens, please put pressure on your governments, on your presidents. Please let them know that you care. Because if the war so easily started here in Ukraine, in the heartland of Europe, very soon the war will not
Bullshit. Elena Ganes, kind enough to join us now. Elena, thank you. How are you holding up?
Yes, hello, I am with you.
How are you doing? How are your children?
We are fine, basically. Thank you very much for asking. So this is Darina, she's 5 months old. So this is Kaita, she's 7 years old. This is Taras, he's 5 years old. And we are really hoping that it will all be okay and we will be alive and happy, and we will be Ukrainian. My husband, the father, he just, right now he's with the other guys and ladies, he is fighting with the Russian aggressor. And Dad said that he thinks that Daddy will not come back, and I told him, no, he will. So we all right.
It's not for the kids, but that's how magicians work. They never let the right hand know what's in their left hand. You get me? And I'm watching these magicians on TV. I'm watching how they work. See, when it comes to my channel, I do not like to repeat myself a lot. I try to come with new information, integration. You get me? And sometimes I fumble because I try to ride some stupid wave about some stupid topic that people find interesting. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me for my follies. Anyway, back to this magician, and we're playing the long game, and we're watching all these people do these magic tricks on TV telling us about Ukraine and stuff like that, and starting it off so early. They start talking about it so we'll get it in our mind. Ukraine.
Nancy Pelosi, Madam Speaker, thank you for coming in again this morning.
My pleasure. Good morning.
You just saw those reports right there. The White House is warning of an imminent invasion of Ukraine. The Ukrainians seem to think that that's all hype. Do you believe that Putin is poised to invade?
Well, I think we have to be prepared for it, and that is what the president is. Yes, I do believe that he is prepared for an invasion. I also understand why the president of Ukraine wants to keep people calm and that he wants his economy not to suffer. But on the other hand, if we were not threatening the sanctions and the rest, it would guarantee that Putin would invade. Let's hope that diplomacy works.
If you take over Ukraine, we're going to sanction you, they say. Sanction? Well, that's a pretty weak statement. Putin is saying, oh, they're going to sanction me. They sanctioned me for the last 25 years. You mean I can take over a whole country and they're going to sanction me? You mean they're not going to blow us to pieces, at least psychologically? The problem is not that Putin is smart, which of course he's smart, but the real problem is that our leaders are dumb.
It's about diplomacy deterrence. Diplomacy deterrence, and the president's made it very clear. There's a big price to pay for Russia to go there. So if Russia doesn't invade, it's not that he never intended to. It's just that the sanctions
work. Russia's taking over Ukraine. We got to protect Ukraine and all the kids and all this stuff like this. This is how they set up the magic trick. This is how they set us up. They use kids.
This is Darina. She's 5 months old. This is Kaita. She's 7 years old. This is Taras. He's 5 years old.
You get me? Even when it comes to, look, I just saw a video. It was so stupid. It was the Super Bowl. Look, I didn't watch no Super Bowl. I don't give a fuck if two men play sports. There you go. You get what I'm saying? I guess, whatever. Gladiators. Okay. I don't care about that. And I don't give a shit about no halftime show. But anyway, one of them popped up and it caught my attention, I guess, because people was talking about it. But it was the one with LeBron James talking to his younger self. How the fuck you gonna go back in time and jerk yourself off? That's basically what you did. Am I ready? No, bitch. You was never ready. You get what I'm saying?
Like you, I detest those who prey upon the gullibility of the masses.
I watch that shit, and people looking at it like, oh, it's LeBron, he's doing something for the community. But that's what they want you to see and stuff. But the thing, he's selling fucking electric cars and shit like that. They got electric cars. Man, get the fuck out of here. Lex, didn't talk about them little easily destructible cars. That's what it is. It looks like it runs on tears or something. You get what I'm saying? It runs on tears, on liberal tears. You get me? It runs on trigger warnings and shit like that. Anyway, I hated that video. So I'm watching everything on TV, and I'm looking at all the pieces, and I'm looking at all the people, and I'm looking at all these magicians trying to set up all these tricks.
There were some reports about discrimination of people with Arabic or African roots.
And shit, and it really makes me mad because nobody's seen it. Think about it like this: J.J. Abrams said it best when he was talking about the Star Wars and subverting people's expectation. Don't that sound like something a fucking magician would say?
Lying through your fucking teeth. I know it, you know it, and this fucking hoe know it.
Come on, leave him alone.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? That's a magician's word, and that's exactly what's happening right now. You had Donald Trump in office, but he was bad. You get me? He was bad. They subverted your expectations. They made you think one thing when it was in the other hand.
Under Bush, Russia invaded Georgia. Under Obama, Russia took Crimea. Under Biden, Russia invaded Ukraine. I stand as the only president of the 21st century on whose watch Russia did not invade another country.
You get what I'm saying? And then they get Biden in office. Voila, it's magic.
Just say the magic word.
Blow me.
That'll suffice.
Oh, yes.
Really? Or is it a setup? You get me? I told you, when it comes to the long game, everything is being put into place while you think that nobody's doing anything. You think that the show starts at 7 o'clock. Boom. So 6:59, I'm gonna jump up, put some clothes on, walk on stage, and let's get started. Hell no. The show started 8 o'clock that morning. You get me? Because we're up looking at the prospects of what we need to do to pull out these magic tricks. Oh, we got to bring the kids into it. It's all about the children. We got to make sure they think about the children while we're performing this magic trick. We got to tell them that Russia, we started it. We already set it up years ago.
I organize.
When it came to Trump, Russian collusion, we got to set it up. Then we got to talk about Ukraine.
What are your plans toward American citizens who are in Ukraine and might be there during an invasion? What scenarios would you put American troops to rescue and get Americans out?
There's not. That's a world war. When Americans and Russians start shooting at one another, we're in a very different world than we've ever been in.
Not even on behalf of simply evacuating Americans?
No. How do you do that? How do you even find them?
We gotta bring this in. We gotta let them know, because we have to get this trick down right, because we only got one shot. So there we are, and here we are. When 7 o'clock come, now we going to fucking war.
What makes me so mad is, like, y'all are so insensitive. Nobody goes into the military wanting to go to war, thinking they're gonna go to war. I'm financed, for crying out loud. Nobody thinks this is gonna happen. I'm scared as hell right now.
Anyway, it's magic. Bye.